What's up, everybody? It's your boy Nick Needles coming at you with another great video. I was actually going to take a week off YouTube this week just because I'm so busy with school and work right now. It's quite ridiculous. But then, of course, Supreme said, we're going to drop all this fire so that Nick Needles has to talk about them and make videos. So thank you, James Jebbia. I really appreciate it. But in all seriousness, thank you for watching this video. Definitely subscribe if you're new and leave a like. We are going to be doing a live cop this Thursday trying to secure one of these box logos, so stay tuned. Also, turn on post notifications so you don't miss another video and follow my Instagram, NickNoodlesYT. So let's start with these long sleeve box logos. I made a whole video in depth on how to cop these yesterday, so definitely check that out if you haven't already. But this is probably the best item of the week and maybe even of the season because of their retail. They should be around $48 to $54, and I see these reselling right away for $400 plus on day one. Maybe some colorways doing 300 plus. Once the market settles down and everyone has their shirts in hand, I see a lot of these colorways dipping to the low 300s and maybe even into like the 250s. We saw the bandana box logos dip the 200, and I think even some sold for like 190 or whatever, which is kind of crazy, but people just wanted to make that quick flip, get like a quick $100 and call it a day. Those aren't really going up that much in price, and it's already been like a year. If you're gonna hold certain colors, it would definitely be the black one, the red on gray, the red on white, and then maybe the green and purple one. I think the rest of them I would just quick sell because I don't see their price going up that much over time. And if they were to go up over time, they're not going to be worth holding in my opinion. I don't want to spend a lot of time repeating myself from yesterday's video, so definitely check that out. Next we have the toothpaste, and this is a pretty good item to cop with like a t-shirt or some of the beanies and hats. I definitely wouldn't try to, you know, multi-cart stuff with the box logo. Focus on that and then go back and start doing your other double cards, triple cards, whatever you want. But this is a pretty fire accessory. It's going to come with some pretty good packaging, I think. It should have like a red box that like toothpaste usually comes in. And that'll have nice Supreme branding on it. If you get this in a multi-cart, you can easily make $15 to $20 on it, especially if you sell it locally. The retail should be under $20. If it's over $20, I would not buy this unless like you want it for the personal. But it's just toothpaste, you know. Don't spend over $20 on toothpaste. It's quite ridiculous. Next, we have these crewnecks, and I'm a little disappointed they released these during Box Logo Week. If these weren't releasing, like, in the month of October when we're getting the North Face collaboration, then I would definitely cop this for the personal. I'm probably not going to go for one for resale either, just because I want to prioritize all my money into these box logos. But this is a pretty nice item. The retail should be around $138 to $148 since it doesn't have any embroidery on it. They're a pretty good hold item because they are a collaboration and they are going to be in a lot more demand due to the weather getting colder. I don't think the tees are doing that well right now on the market. You can make some decent lunch money. These are very good hold items. I definitely see that black and white colorway hitting 200 plus on day one in size small and XL. The other colorways will probably be $20 or $30 over retail. But again, it's just gonna go up over time, so this is definitely a good item to cop. Next, we have the big logo beanies and the velvet camp cap. For the beanies, I think all of them are good choices just because they have that fat spell out. That's what the Hypebeast love. They love that loud branding. All the colorways are pretty decent too. That orange one is gonna be pretty nice for the fall. That gives me spooky season vibes. For the velvet camp cap, you're gonna wanna go for the black colorway. I don't know about any of the other ones, but I know for a fact that that black one will do pretty decent and sell for probably $70 to $80. So definitely, you know, pick this up with like a t-shirt or maybe even the crew neck if you want. That would be a good cart to go for. Next, we have all the other summer tees. Now, the thing with t-shirts are, one, you want to cop as many as you can in a multi-cart as possible. It helps you save on tax and shipping, and it also helps you increase your profit margins. I think I bought like 4 or 5 tees in one cart last season, and they averaged out to like $48 a tee. Now, if you were to buy it individually in a single cart, you're gonna spend around $60 to $65 per tee, and that really just cuts into your margins because Supreme tees really don't sell like they used to. If I'm gonna pick some to go for, I would probably go for the Sun tee, the Pills tee, and the Ultra Fresh tee. I really don't like the Smurfs tee. I like the mock-up they did so much better. This one kind of looks like a vintage tee, and I don't really like it. The Dix tee is probably the worst tee I've ever seen. People have been memeing that. I really don't know if that's gonna resell. I don't think it will. And the clientele one, that one's all right as well as the scratch one. But I think the best ones are probably going to be the Sun tee, the Pills tee, and the Ultra Fresh. Go for those black colorways. It's gonna be the safest in XL and probably large. Those will probably be the easiest to grab. You can also look at some of the one-off colors. That like pink color on the Dick's tee is not that bad. If they have that colorway in all the other tees, I would definitely first prioritize those box logos and then see what's left on these tees. Try to get all the black colorways in one cart and try to do a single checkout. Lastly, we have the bricks and the personals. So the whole Fox collaboration, I'm going to go ahead and say it's a brick. Hopefully I'm not wrong on that. I mean, maybe the black colorways in those items could do well, but there's just better items to go for. The flannel they're doing this week, I mean, it's not a bad piece, but it's probably going to be over $100, and who wants to pay $100 for a flannel? The hockey jersey, that dragon one, is actually pretty fire, I'm not going to lie. I don't think it's going to resell that well. It's probably going to sit on the site for another week or two. And then lastly, we have these wool crewnecks. These ones aren't that bad, but I think the Futura logo ones are a better investment. But yeah, those aren't a bad item for the personal. It'll definitely be cozy for the holiday season. So that pretty much wraps up the video. Stay tuned for Thursday because we are doing a live cop and you don't want to miss me either take an L or take a W. Hopefully it's take a W, but best of luck to you all. Make sure you check out that box logo video I made yesterday so that you ensure you cop these box logos. But yeah, I will see you all on Thursday.